second topic that we want to focus on, and that is the vaccines. Now, Dutch health officials have said that they have suspended the use of AstraZeneca as a COVID vaccine for 2 weeks after possible side effects were reported in Denmark and Norway, so becoming the latest country in Europe to pause the AstraZeneca vaccine. On the other hand, AstraZeneca has said it had conducted a review of people vaccinated with its COVID vaccine, which has shown no evidence of any increased risk of blood clots. The review covered more than 17 million people vaccinated in the European Union and United Kingdom. The World Health Organization, too, has backed the vaccine and said its benefits far outweigh any concerns. And the UK as well has been defending the vaccine. Many concerns in India, as this is one of the two vaccines that we use here. It's called Covishield in India, the AstraZeneca Oxford vaccine. Well, doctors, I want to bring you back here to get your views on this. And Dr. Deshmukh, first to you, what do you feel? Are they being overly cautious in Europe? Because we've seen, you know, country after country suddenly saying this, but you have the WHO backing it. AstraZeneca has also come out with its statistics. And in India as well, we have full confidence in this vaccine.
Kargi, the learned audience has to understand that the COVID disease itself is fraught with a lot of microemboli to start with. That's the whole idea, that patients with COVID have been started on low molecular weight heparin, that is blood thinners, all the time. And this jab of vaccine which we are going to give, any kind of vaccine, the immunogenicity of the vaccine is going to trigger a small response within the body. And this response from the body can be in the form of microemboli, which can be taken care of the body itself. But these microemboli are of not very clinically significant nature. However, one point of caution here, that the incidence of emboli after the vaccination is much, much lower than the general incidence of embolism, either the pulmonary embolism or microemboli anywhere in the organs of the body is much less.
All right, Dr. Mehta, and your view on this, as you know, many doctors who I've spoken to before about this whole this issue, they're saying that, you know, this is just being overly cautious, and the benefits, as the WHO says, far outweighs any of these incidents.
So there's a general worldwide diktat which will come out, and then there's population specific issues. The worldwide diktat, based on a humongous amount of experiences, doesn't look like it's a problem. But individual countries who have population-specific issues have the right to figure out what's wrong, what's going on in their populations. For example, if in your community, in your population, with your demographics, you notice a particular issue, then obviously those countries and the regulators have a responsibility to do it. That doesn't mean it's happening in my country or with me. So this sort of, you know, think globally, but look at your local problems is also applicable. And so it's right that those countries will look at their issues. Our point of view, it doesn't mean that we jump, because we have to look at our data. And if it's okay in our population, as my colleagues have pointed out, we proceed in this direction.
Right. And Dr. Raj Singh, you know, initially when we started the vaccination drive, there was some amount of hesitancy being seen. You know, people really did question whether, you know, the vaccine has been produced in such a short period of time, a record period of time. So there were certain doubts among doctors and medical people as well, because they were the ones in the first phase who didn't turn up for their vaccines. Do you fear that, you know, now with what's happening in Europe, again, it'll cause some amount of concerns here in India or some amount of hesitancy? And what would your message be?
Yes, of course, there are theoretical concerns regarding this particular vaccine about the possibility of producing clots. But I have taken that vaccine, so have most of my colleagues, and there hasn't been any problem as such. And I think looking at the benefit of this vaccine, it certainly should be encouraged that everyone should take it. There have been some hesitancy, partly because of fears of side effect, and partly because of the feeling that maybe they don't need it anymore. But I think we will have to encourage everyone to take the vaccine, whether it is the Covishield or the Covaxin, whichever vaccine is available, people should continue to have it. I think the side effects which have been found are not really clearly established.
Right. Dr. Deshmukh, in India, what has our experience been so far? There have been one or two cases, you know, reported here and there of certain side effects. So for our viewers, if you could just tell us.
In India, or in particularly in the city of Mumbai, what we have seen is the COVID-related vaccination drive has been very successful. The associated side effects or complications that we are seeing are not serious enough to warrant any kind of intervention by the state or by the country itself or by the any authorities who are trying to govern the supply of the vaccine itself. But one thing you should understand that the ethnicity of India is such that the general incidence of microemboli as well as pulmonary embolism is quite low as compared to the European population. So the complication rate in India is almost zero, and I would encourage everybody to go ahead with the vaccine irrespective of what the data outside India shows. And I think the data from India should be robust once it comes out within the next 3 months.
All right. Well, thank you so much, doctors, for joining us today on the show and sharing your opinions on all these various matters that are concerning right now. Thank you so much.
Thank you.